Hello viewers, I'm SB and welcome back to the Curious Expedition. So we have a couple of interesting choices here. I think we're not going to this jungle. It has two climbing shrines and a mission, which is fine but not terribly exciting. I think what it really comes down to is this pair of mummies versus a temple. An early temple can be really valuable. I think we're going to go for the temple. Also, I'm kind of curious whether or not there are new temple effects. A scientist approached me with a mysterious box buried somewhere in the area where I traveled to. Yep, okay. I will do it. I will find your mysterious box, sir. Alright, so, how are we doing on crew? We got a pair of soldiers and a native animal handler. I have a rifle, so I'd like to get another blue dye if possible. However, we also have access to a cook here. Now, granted, this cook is an alcoholic, but we can hope to get that resolved. And I really do like the combination of British soldier and cook. And we might boot the Scottish soldier. Yeah, let's do it. Whatever. We'll just rock one blue die, I guess. Pretty sure the native animal handler never gets another die. I think Parsi Trader gets a blue die at like level 3. Whatever, we're taking the cook. The sanity gain from the cook is just, it's so high. Very difficult to turn them down. Alright, let us bring a huge amount of chocolate. We have pretty good medical supplies. We should probably bring a shovel, you know, for digging, where the scientist tells us to. And we're going to the desert, so we don't need a lot of special traversal gear. We have 55 funds left, so what we could do is buy all the weather balloons and then pop them right away at the beginning of the adventure. The other thing we could do is buy a bunch of machetes and then bank. We don't have a capacity upgrade. So I could like buy 2 machetes with the intent of using them for trade and then buy an animal improvement. Let's try that. So we have a lot of junk in our inventory that I'm not actually going to take with us out into the expedition. We picked up some stuff at the end there. Actually, I guess, let's see, does it look like I see a village? I don't think so. Alright, so we're definitely not taking these, because we're just saving those for the future. I think we're going to leave the spear behind. Like, we could take it for trade value, but it's not a huge amount of trade value, and right now our arms are pretty full, and I might leave the red mushroom behind as well for the same reason. We need a little bit more space to carry all the stuff that we're going to pick up, potentially. And we have 4 first aid kits on. I think we'll be fine. Yeah, I hope we'll be fine. Alright, we definitely need to carry water with us as well. May as well fill up all of the inventory spaces that we can here. We'll drop that. And I'm very excited to have a cook. This is good news. Alright, let's go have a look around, shall we? Okay, a stone circle. I like that a lot. This vessel is named the Black Rock. Ooh, nice. Okay. Play the drums and drop one of the stacks of water. I probably don't need to carry 4 stacks of water. We'll be okay. So yeah, let's hit this and ask for settlements. By the way, that is a giant crab. I have no idea what it's doing in the middle of the desert, but the giant crab is dangerous. Okay. We're at 1 standing, so it's the time to go for it. I'm nervous about a giant crab. I've had a lot of bad experiences with the giant crab. Please don't come over here. Do I need to level anybody up? I don't think so. Oh, wow, they're going to give us free food. Nice. Okay, so let's trade. Oh, wow, they have a number of useful items. We have all of these machetes that I brought to trade. And also, what else do they want? We could give them some food cans. We give them some of our dynamite. I'm not huge on parting with dynamite, but I'm not that huge on parting with food either. I'm just thinking we need to make space. So we could do this. Do I want to pick up a second drum? This is going to bring me down two inventory slots and then up one, so we're actually going to have to toss two stacks of water as it is. Unless I trade them, something else. Oh, I didn't even look at the treasure map, man. Man, I'm dumb. Okay, let's, don't have any mangoes or anything. Do I want to trade to up my standing? I think the answer is maybe. The answer is possibly, who can say. Let's try resting. The people of the tribe were celebrating a wedding. The ritual was quite intricate and fascinating. The couple seemed quite tense to my eyes. Strange. When I saw how the couple looked at each other, I understood they were able to choose freely, just like we do. Well, that's cool. Let's study their culture. I'm just going to throw away all my stuff, whatever. Sleep. Okay, interesting. Our extended presence was perceived well by the natives. The wedding ritual was still ongoing. The villagers seemed lost in thought and prayer. Leaving their village now would be considered a great offense. This is new. Alright, well, you know what? Let's trade them some other stuff. Let's lighten our load a little bit and get some standing. And we'll just stay here another night because I kind of want to anyway. Torches, and I don't feel great about giving away all the dynamite, because, you know, dynamite is great. But we do want to lower the number of objects that we are carrying. I need to free up, let me think, these are 15 sanity each, right? So this is going to be 45 to put us. So, really, we could just leave now. And I know that our standing would take a hit, that seems to be what that text was implying, but, but we're never going to see another village, probably. I think there's only one village here. We only saw one in the preview. So we might be able to just ignore having bad standing. I guess we should... Well, we don't need to lighten our load too much, because we do have a level that we could bestow on the animal handler to buy us another inventory space, too. Alright, let's go ahead and trade the dynamite, I guess. I don't feel great about it, but we'll buy some standing. We'll free up an inventory space. We'll rest again. In a quiet moment, one of the village elders gave us a serious look and asked if we knew who had created mankind. Okay, I don't... None of our crew members are particularly religious. I'm gonna say evolution. In our opinion, humans were a natural result of evolution. He nodded quietly as he listened to our explanation. Huh. The wedding ritual was still ongoing. The villagers were dancing and celebrating young love. Leaving now would be considered a great offense, still. Will they let me rest one more time for free? They will. And then they're going to try to get us drunk, and I will refuse. Okay. The wedding ceremony had ended. The village returned to normal, though some people here seemed awfully tired and receptive to loud noises. Okay. That was interesting. So let us, first of all, actually do this. A mountain north of a cactus forest space with a lot of desert nearby. And it's just a single mountain? I guess we can't really see what else is around it. But it looks to me like we don't see that. I don't see that anywhere. If we're holding the map upside down, this would be kind of right. Well, I guess we'll just keep an eye out. Okay, we are one item slot over. I think right now I would rather drop water than give the animal handler the level, because we might want to buy like two levels on our cook or something, depending on how things work out with inventory space and with how much meat we find. So what do I think this is? This could be a shrine. Well, let's go find out. It is indeed. So we're at -3 standing already. Do we want to push it? It's a volcano shrine. I kind of want to leave this and come back to it later, but if we take it now, yeah, let's do it. If we take it now, we don't have to worry about coming back later, which could be, oh, that village. Actually, this might be really good. The village might get obliterated, which, I mean, that's a horrible thing to sound excited about, but yeah, it'd be pretty okay for us, actually. All right, I'm going to eat all the meat that we have, and I am going to go ahead and level up our animal handler. Alright, we need to go to the mission as quickly as possible. think we should be pretty safe headed this way. Oof. Nope, the fire spread very quickly and we walked through a fire space. Okay, apparently the mission is not accessible from here. We would need to come in either from the north or from the south. Well, we really do need to get rid of some of this stuff. I want to drop some of these things off. So I guess let's see what this is. Wait, let's play the drums first. Let's see what this is, and we'll come to the thing from this side. Come on, don't aggro that crab. Alright. Oh, it's a trader. If we interact with the trader, he disappears and he doesn't come back, as far as I'm aware. So I think maybe what we want to do is go fight a hyena. And then come back to him with loot. Because we don't really have a lot of stuff to trade right now, but I would like to have stuff to trade. Okay, should be relatively straightforward. I guess I do have two blue dice, don't I? We want... Actually, that was maybe not the right play. So we could get quick shot plus kick. We actually can't even kill a second hyena, is that right? Actually, I want the rest of these to come off shield, don't I? Okay, quick shot plus shielding. 4 points of shielding might be enough to make us take zero damage. Nope, bleeds. Unfortunately, bleed damage hits no matter what, so... That's unfortunate. That's very unfortunate. Okay, let's... Right now, this is 4 damage, plus the shotgun is 6. If we can pull Ripper Leap off... Okay, we did. So let's go Ripper Leap on you. And... Quick shot you, and then what the hell, we have the shotgun, let's finish it. Okay, good stuff. How much sanity is it to walk back in range? 37, so if we ate one meat, or if we ate one chocolate, we can make the walk, and then we can decide what to do with our inventory after we've used the trader. I think let's do that. I know this is a couple spaces of very inconvenient, or very inefficient movement. But I think it's worth it. He's not showing us the good stuff. Could not help but think he had more valuables to sell. Well, the temple pendulum is potentially interesting, and it doesn't take up space, right? So let's give him all of this stuff that we got specifically for this purpose. We'll buy, like, a temple pendulum and a ton of food. What can I trade him that's worth a small amount? Nothing, really. This isn't bad, though. I can round out the trade by taking a single water off of him. Yeah, this isn't too bad. I guess the taking a single water... I'm going to drop a slot of water anyway. Or maybe I'm going to eat all this meat. I don't know. There's no sense leaving value on the table, though. Okay. Anything that doesn't take up an inventory space is a good place to store value while you try to figure out what to do with it later. I guess we can level up our cook once and then get 15 sanity from eating the meat. Or I'm gonna try to save the meat until it's worth a little bit more. Because we should be able to get him to level 2, I would think. Alright, so we can do that. And we can use this guy's... Oh, hold up. Let's play the drums before we do anything. So that if we stay here, the timer on the drums is ticking down. So let's access the storage room, throw treasure in there. Okay. Now let's see, what does he want? What can we give him to let us stay? This actually would not be a terrible way to trade the meat. Alright, trading chocolate doesn't make any sense. 30 value either way. Or it's 30 sanity for sleeping here, or pay him 30 sanity worth of chocolate. But we could give him the temple pendulum, which I don't particularly care for. And, like, 2 meat to let us stay here once. This is maybe 20 sanity worth of meat if we do manage to get the second level up. It's probably fine. I will refuse to drink his extra whiskey, which for some reason lowers my sanity. I don't know why. Game balance, I guess, is why, but still I don't like it. Alright, let's just move on. So this is almost certainly the Blessing Temple, right? Yep. Alright, let's hope it's a good one. There's an ornamental chalice filled with clear liquid standing atop the altar. Well, I love our cook, but I think I'm going to give it to our British soldier. Pure mind. What is pure mind? Immune to mental... Okay. So you can't get mental debuffs. That's maybe the worst one I've seen. That's not very good at all. Okay. Well, we can come down here and probably get in a fight. We can take a giant bird. And at this point, with it only being Expedition 3, I would be very surprised if it was two giant birds. This hyena thinks he's clever. Trying to bait us into coming forward. So, what is the best way for me to get kills here? Aimed shot plus, like, sword and shield would give me a kill that allows me to still try to get Ripper Leap for a second kill. I think that's what we have to do. Okay, I really need this to come up. Not blank. Yeah, if this comes up man plus we get hand, we can get the second kill, and if this comes up sword, we can get the second kill. And also I'd really like foot. Okay. Or, hand. So that's not good. We didn't get what we were looking for there. That being the case, I guess let's go ahead and do a plan shot. Quick shot this guy, and we'll, shielded riposte as well. And then we'll just take two extra points of shielding. Hopefully, nobody gets a bite. Okay, good. We just shield all the damage. Okay, so I'm hedging against the bad potential results here. We don't have it. What we could do right here is go shotgun blast to kill one and weaken the other. And then hope for a Ripper Leap or to roll gun plus eye. Well, okay. I put this die back because it was, you know, there's a decent chance of this coming up blank. I guess it didn't matter. We had the kill no matter what happened, pretty much. Alright, let's walk to here so that we reveal this. I'm sure it's a cave and we won't be able to interact with it because I traded all of our torches. But it will give us an exploration point. Alright, I want to fight this giant bird, I think. Are you actually... I haven't gotten anything to drink in a long time. Alright, so you have 18 health and are very dangerous. But if we can get a rifle shot off, that'll do 12. And then we could get man plus shotgun to go to 17. And then be out of ways to deal damage. That's no good. The other rifle combo, just going with eye, so that I have a mind left over to do Ripper Leap with, would Ripper Leap plus shotgun attack would only be 10 damage. So it's better to do the plus the rifle attack. So it's better to do the full rifle attack. We may just be eating a ton of damage here. So the best case scenario for us damage-wise is to roll man. And that gets us 3 damage in addition to whatever else we're going to roll, basically. Yeah, I'm going to get hit. It's going to hurt. Okay, and that actually went like pretty poorly. So we'll take our masterful shot and our points of shielding, and then he's going to hit us for roughly a billion. That hurts. But this turn we got him. right? What's he at? Six? Okay, I'm gonna need things to go slightly better than they're going. Actually, no, I don't. This is six. Impost and quick shot. Okay. I guess I had Ripper Leap there too. Okay, so that's a bunch more meat, which is a bunch more sanity. Plus, we got some bird feathers. I think that's probably an oasis, and it really sucks that we have to stop on the way there. So, given that our cook is angry, do I want to change up my plan here? I probably should have tried to buy some whiskey, but whiskey is usually pretty expensive. A lot of people overvalue it. Alright, I'm gonna eat a likely bad event here. Louis Popochet has become bipolar. Alright, well, he couldn't get any more disloyal, so I guess that's not a big deal. Hmm. Sergeant Henry Sanders and Louis Popochet was sharing his tent this night again. I could hear scandalous language from within. Filthy animals, the lot. Huh. Alright, let's rest one more time. I guess we may as well go to fall. We'll pick up some more water, too. Which we will almost certainly end up discarding, but, you know. Better to leave discarded water bottles everywhere than to die of thirst. I think that should be a fairly uncontroversial statement. Alright, let's head down here. I have no idea where the pyramid is going to be. That could be it. Please tell me this is passable. Yes. Alright, this, I think, is very likely the thing we're looking for. I think we're going to lose our cook. I'm concerned. Unfortunately, it took us just too long to get here, and we're going to end up getting a pretty bad time score. This would be 110 travel costs, so that's not happening all in one go. Alright, so it's time to head back, and this would be a good time to check and see if we did, in fact, figure out where the hell this buried box is. Could be here. Right, the map shows that there is green ground two columns to the right. Could be this ground, so it could be this could be the cactus field shown in the picture. Alright, well let's do I want to risk leveling him? You know what, I'm going to go ahead and use our level points, and I know that maybe I will get totally boned on this. Alright, we're just going to really hope that we don't lose him. It's possible that this is passable, but I didn't feel like it was sensible to take the risk. Okay, that's a shrine. Do I want to use it? I think the answer is no. I think we go on here first. And then we maybe hit this on the way back, just in case it's something scary. Yeah, this is definitely right. Oh, and there's another thing here, too. 35 travel cost. Okay. Let's break into the meat. This could be an abandoned campsite, maybe? Another ship? Sure. Animal tracks. That's excellent. Ooh, that's also excellent. Okay, a giant scorpion. Cool. And we found some bullets. I do not want to carry these around, so we'll probably use them. Although we may not have to. Is that lethal yet? Yeah, this is lethal. Because we have the two gun combos that we need. Where did my gun die go? It's underneath one of my other dice. Oh no, we don't have the... I just didn't roll it yet. This is fine. Spoke too soon. Thought it was going to be fine. Well, let's not take any damage. So we can throw dynamite at him. Or, actually, the three bullets, what does he have, seven health? Three bullets is actually perfect, because we get precise attack, riposte, and riposte. Ah, beautiful. Okay, we cook all the meat and eat it immediately. And then it's the space down and to the left from the cactuses. Cacti? Oh, there's something over here, too. Well, I don't think we want to go back for it. So we dig and we excavate something valuable hidden beneath the surface. Alright, we are not opening the box. He explicitly told me not to open it. And listen, I'm not going to lie and tell you that I'm good at following directions. What I am going to tell you is that I've opened the box in the past, and I shouldn't have, and I will never make that mistake again. Oh, that's inconvenient. The volcanoes are going off right as we're approaching. Some of the village has not been obliterated by the volcanoes yet. Oh, we don't have any rope. I don't think that I do want to attempt this without any climbing gear. The chance of losing somebody's too high. And I like my people. And the animal handler totally does get a blue dye at level 3. That's where the other blue dye came from. So it turns out I don't know what the hell I'm talking about. Listen, I played a lot of this game, but it was a while ago. Alright, so if we eat a bunch of our chocolates, where are we going to run into this guy? Somewhere over here. Fighting this guy is actually going to be really good for us. Alright, let's wait. So we're going to get 15 sanity plus whatever they drop, and it could be food. We're definitely going for dynamite on this one. That's a huge number of toots. Okay, I don't love that. So I need rifle. I mean, I guess nothing really matters unless we roll the guns. Except I could get Ripper Leap. Yeah, so let's keep these. Rolling a shield will allow me to combo with the sword. Okay, so we didn't really get a lot there. We got a riposte. And hopefully this guy doesn't give us a wound that gets infected. That's basically all that comes down to. There we go, finally rolled a gun. Okay. Oh, alright. So I'm going to use my green mushroom to cleanse the negative mental effects. It doesn't cleanse angry, but we cleansed his bipolar and his alcoholism. So if we can get his loyalty back up, we'll probably be able to keep it up. We also found 3 horn flutes as bananas. Okay, so what am I going to drop? I could eat all the chocolate. We could toss the water. And I guess the coca leaves? I could use the coca leaves, but I just got everybody clear of negative stuff. Okay, yeah, let's toss the water, and this should be sufficient. Nope. Needed the water to make the trip possible, but also needed to not have the water in my inventory to make the trip possible. A catch 22. Well, I guess the only thing to do is to walk. It doesn't look like there's any. Even the most direct path gets us, yeah, 16 days, 5th place. There was a bit of zigzagging still. Yeah, well, nothing for it. I guess we just walk and have a bad time. So we go to here as efficiently as possible, and then we just move in the fewest possible number of days. We should get exactly 1 low sanity event, which could be really, really bad. Oh, wait. Cancel. If we let these guys catch up with us, the sanity gain from fighting plus whatever food they have on them might get us to the ship without a sanity event. Who would have thought that all these murderous natives would be so helpful? Okay, so we got kick plus gun. That'll do it. 15 sanity plus no food. Okay. You don't need you. I don't think I'm gonna need to heal her. And there's not anything I would rather have. Nope. Okay, that gets me back. The sanity from fighting them plus playing the drums once more gets me back in time. And then we're not actually playing for anything at this point. So do I just like wait for these guys to approach us? We're already in fifth place. Speed means nothing. I guess waiting is increasing the chance of me getting an event from the cook where he tells me he's never going to see me again. So yeah, that's actually probably a pretty good reason not to hang around. Show me sword. I'm not seeing sword. Okay, well this is actually lethal, so let's do this. Ripper leap on one guy, quick shot another guy, and kick the last guy to death, which is horrifying. And I'm gonna take all this stuff, and we're gonna leave. We have this this stockpile of just like pretty crummy items, but still free items on the ship. So if we if something goes horribly wrong, we can at least try to rebuild from that. So navigator's pretty bad, waterproof is whatever, and bullet hoarder is fine. Take bullet hoarder. That was a choice between an okay perk and two perks that I do not care for very much. So 1080 after Expedition 3 is okay. It's not a game-smashing score, but it's certainly one where I expect we should be able to win. Right, gift. I think we keep the animal parts for trade. These ones, it's a little more tricky. I'd love to keep the bird feathers for trade because they do have a higher value than funding. But also, how much stuff do we really want to carry around? I'm going to sell these. This I think I'm actually going to gift. And then we're going to gift all this stuff. Okay, first place. By about 100, not incredible, but totally fine. Buried Golden Pyramid, and Buried Golden Pyramid. Okay, so do I feel that this is a crew that can handle the Arctic? We have the ability to make a lot of sanity out of combat. And I really like that. But I think we're going to go for the drylands instead. We don't have any of the cool vision stuff that I'd like for the Arctic, and also this has a temple, so. Alright, here's your box, sir. Please give me lots of money. A trader proposed an offer. He tasked me to acquire a precious idol. We will refuse. If we find the idol, we will keep it for ourselves. Okay, none of these crew members are blowing my mind. Did we get a little bit of loyalty for... Yep, okay, for finishing the mission. Right, and with his alcoholism gone, it should be fairly easy to keep it unless... Okay, good. I was going to say, unless the only thing we have available to eat here is whiskey. Alright, we have a torch, but I'll buy another one, I guess. And then we will... Let's stay in the ship. I can't believe the mango survived the voyage. So probably what's staying in the ship is... Will the mango just be okay in there? I'm as soon as we walk with the mango, it's going to spoil, which is a little silly. But maybe we're mostly good aside from the food. Okay, why don't we take food plus weather balloons, and then spend 100 funds on an upgrade and just bank the rest? We'll figure out exactly what's staying. Well. Let's also bring machetes, because trade value. Alright, saddle upgrade. I would love to have found a cooler pack animal by now, but we have had no such luck. I didn't even try at the village in the last area, because desert villages almost always only have camels available, and I think the camel might actually be the worst pack animal. At least, in general, broadly. It's not terrible for deserts. I think it gets extra sanity reduction in deserts. Why don't we leave the coca leaf? I'm not going to take the green mushroom with us, but we can remember that it's here and clear a mental effect at the end of the this expedition. So this would leave us with a couple of slots open. I don't know, there's not really a point in taking the mango, but there's also not really a point in leaving it, so. And we'll take a little bit of water just in case we hit a desert shrine. Okay, I'm going to pop these weather balloons right now. Let's get some idea what we're looking at here. Okay. This is Expedition 4, so there should only be one seal. You don't see buried pyramids until Expedition 4, generally. And the way it works is there's one seal on 4, 2 on 5, and 3 on 6. Alright, so this is a good opportunity to eat this blue mushroom, give us a little bit more vision. Well, we'll be able to make use of the missionary right away. We'll hit the shrine and then drop off the loot from the shrine at the mission. Up here there's a panther. I want to hit this, but I'm not sure what I want to search for with it. I guess let's do this first. We might even save the ship until the end. What is that? There's like poisonous gas clouds. I think that's new. Let's reveal camp points. Okay, so there is a desert area actually up north. With an oasis and everything. So we could ignore the shrine for now and do it on the way back so as not to obliterate our standing. It means I don't have any particular burning need to visit that mission. Alright, what do we got? The Fancy. That's a remarkably unfancy name for a ship. And we attracted hungry wildlife, which is wonderful. Let's go ahead and give this dude a level. Get a little bit more sanity from defeating these hyenas, and again, let's just not even worry about it. Kabam. Problem solved. Okay, this crew would really like that gun damage perk. That'd be really nice. So I think I'm gonna leave this for the end. We'll hit this on the way out. So I'm gonna save the meat then. Let's head up here and see what the deal is with the poisonous gas. I've never seen clouds of poisonous gas just drifting over the land. Okay, I see. I see what is causing them. So let's go to here. It'll be 23 sanity. Go to here. We'll trigger the seal and then we'll get out of here. Okay, beautiful. Well, this has been very easy so far. Remarkably easy. Far too easy, suspiciously easy, you know, however you want to put it. Ooh. Well, we have plenty of hyena parts to trade him, so let's have a look. Still not showing us the good stuff. Unfortunately, as far as I know, there's nothing you can do. Sometimes they show you the good stuff, sometimes they don't. Alright, so we're definitely offloading all of our teeth and pelts here, where they're super valuable. And we are buying chocolates. And a shrine pendulum, which has no value except, you know, for the actual monetary value of it. Climbing gear? And a torch? Sure. I forgot to make a note of whether there were climbing shrines. The climbable shrines have a different graphic, so you can tell right from the preview. But if there are, we'll want to have some climbing gear on us. And our inventory space is actually, like, in a pretty good spot now. What's it going to take? It's going to get 36 travel cost. Wow, that's a little nuts. And again, I'm just going to eat the chance of a low sanity event. Louis Popochet is mocking me. I'm going to let it slide. I decided that the situation was already stressful enough and did not want to make much trouble over a comparatively minor event. Nevertheless, I observed that Mopi Subexa shook her head disapprovingly. I wondered if she would now think less of me as leader of the group. We did not want to damage the cook's loyalty. The cook is a likely mission-critical member, so. Alright. So I'm curious what that is, and also I want to fight the raptor. Hopefully it's not too many raptors. One raptor can be killed with a single rifle combo. Two raptors would be a little tricky. If it's three raptors, we will absolutely have to use dynamite. Okay, so do I want to use dynamite? All these extra green dice are actually somewhat valuable now. Bullet plus shield, giving 2 damage plus 2 health, is actually really nice. So I think we try to find the shotgun combo. The rifle combo to just kill one straight up, rather than using dynamite. Is that sensible? No, let's dynamite. Because we can rifle combo this way, plus a single bullet shield thing to kill one of them. And then it shouldn't be too hard to find lethal for the other one. So we want to hold on to some number of shields. We'd really like for this to go with the rifle. So I don't want to save this to try to Ripper Leap. And really, we just want shields, right? Like, okay, both of our guns. I'll take this. Yeah, and show me shields. Okay, so we're going to do the small shotgun blast. And we have that, plus that. And you can throw an extra shield on there, but all it does is give you plus 1 shield. It's no different than using the extra shield raw. Okay, there we go. All these extra bullets are actually going to be really useful. Alright, so what is this? Sure, abandoned camp. A Persian explorer, and it's marked heavily by animal tracks, which is like the best thing that could possibly happen. Hell yes, a whole bunch of hyenas. Let's accumulate some damage dice just in case I can't find... Well, I mean, I would throw the dynamite whether or not I find the mine that I'm looking for, but now I don't have to think about it at all. So that's why you're trying to roll mine, so that the dice will do your thinking for you. I don't really want to cook a huge amount of food, because right now our cooking is less efficient than it could be. Let's toss the fireworks. Fireworks, I think can be used to distract animals or something. It's not something that honestly comes up very often. Alright. As before. Oh, it's a shrine pendulum. What I was about to say is, as before, I don't really want to, fight 2 giant birds, but 1 giant bird wouldn't be too bad. I have no idea how to know how many it is, though. I'm pretty sure there's no way for you to know. Alright, it saw us. It's coming. He's aggroed. Let's go ahead and rest since we're above 30 sanity. He'll draw closer as we sleep, and then in the morning we will kill him. They can't attack you while you're resting at the thing for some reason. Okay, just 1 bird. This shouldn't be too bad. So we're really hoping to find man plus combo and then use a bullet. I'm getting a little nervous. Please show me rifle. Okay, that's crappy. So I think what we want to do here is actually use the bullet in conjunction with this to get some actual damage out there. Quick shot him. Stable position plus raw shield, and then just take a huge amount of damage because I can't roll rifle. Oof. Okay, but that's really good in that the birds focused all the damage on one person, so it's only going to take a health kit to fix. Alright. Again, I really don't want to cook any food yet. We can probably just drop the climbing gear. This will just be a normal cave. Wound infected? Yeah, it's fine. That's fine. We brought gauze and whatever medical stuff was in vogue at the time. Probably like a big bottle full of absinthe and a saw. I don't know, listen, I've heard a couple episodes of Sawbones, but I don't really know what was going on back then. All I know is that they were bad at medicine. Do I want to drop my torch? Yeah, we'll probably not hit another valuable cave. This might be a cave. But also it could be a shrine or a waterfall. Or not a shrine, but a temple. There is a temple here. Actually, this is almost certainly the temple, isn't it? Well, let's fight these hyenas. And this will actually put us over our meat stack limit. Let's cook a little bit of meat. So what are you? You're a shrine. You're a temple. Let's go hit the temple. Nope, it's a cave. I thought there was a temple, though, wasn't there? Did I make that up? Am I a big dummy? Well, I dropped my torch. You can try to do it with blue dice, but obviously, it's imperfect. Now let's hit this. We'll hit the shrine on the way back, on the way past. And then we have one more shrine to hit on the way back as well. We need to reveal, I think, two more locations to get the third exploration point. So actually it looks like we can go ahead and start cooking the meat because we're not going to get it. Alright, so let's refill, go to here, see what's what. This is going to be a climbing shrine. When they're on a hill, they usually are. I'm not going to bother. We're doing fine. Everything's fine. Do I want to hit the springs again? How much time do we have? We have 57 days to get out. So what is it? It's to walk to like here is 33 days. I think we'd better not stop at the spring. I think we're going to go to the mission first, dump off the elephant tusks and stuff, and make a little room in our inventory, and then hit the shrine and then hit the boat. So how far can we go? Also, remember there's no point in holding on to meat, so we may as well commit to travel here. We can make it all the way back, but it goes right through the middle of poison gas land. Let's see what the poison gas situation is like. Because the gas clouds do deteriorate, or dissipate rather. Okay, we definitely do want to go around. So that's, I guess, go up on the hills to get around? Hopefully the gas cloud doesn't drift too much, because they did take us right next to it. Oh, there's like stuff over here. Alright, well, this is a time for making a decision. Do I want to go get stuff? Because there was a temple, I swear, right? Am I thinking the right thing? Yeah. I'm pretty sure I am. Or do I want to get the fame of coming in a reasonable space? And I think we gotta get stuff. We gotta go and have a look around. Okay, this is not ideal. We are going to stop cooking meat because now it has become obvious that we absolutely are going to be able to level up our cook. A shaman's hut. That may be incredibly valuable to us, actually. It would be 41 sanity to travel up to here. Alright, so this will get us our shaman's hut plus a little bit of vision. Oh, there's a ton of stuff over here. Okay, what do you have, sir? He has targeted teleportation, extended vision, chasm. Okay. We might be able to pull off a thing with the voodoo doll. Let's see. Let's see what we can buy from him. So nobody has any really, like, upsetting negative mental traits, right? So we don't need to go for any cleansing. We just want to get some stuff. So I wouldn't mind taking this off of his hands as well. What if I trade all this stuff? These are more expensive than I'd like them to be. We could pick up... Yeah, never mind. I'll just do this trade deal. Okay, now we probably have to cook and eat some meat. The other alternative is we can use all the voodoo dolls at once. Oh no, we have the level up points. Yeah, okay, so now we just cook and condense all our meat into one slot. I'm not 100% sure if using all the voodoo dolls at once actually, you know, stacks up the duration of their effects. So that's the only reason I'm reticent to do that. There we go, that's what I was looking for. Let's enter this temple. Let's not put all of our eggs in one basket. We'll give the cook this drink. He's gained inhuman strength. That's handy. Okay, I probably don't want to bother going over here, because it's just going to be a cave that I can't enter. But I do want to come over here, and at least if we move within two spaces of this, we'll reveal what it is. We can figure out whether we care. Oh, it's a village! Also, I just got attacked by hyenas. I actually got hit by hyenas. What an embarrassment. Alright, let's pop the last dynamite off real quick. Take off. So I'm at negative 6 standing. Yeah, let's go ahead and talk to these guys. We might be able to at least trade stuff off of them. Okay. We're going to put them at ease with some gifts. Yep, definitely worth the trip. So, what would they like? Probably some hyena pelts would do it. Yeah. We're not going to be able to stay with them. So let's buy some mangoes too. Deal. Okay, cool. Let's get the hell out of here. We're being followed. That's fine. I don't care about that. Oh, did they have torches? They didn't. Okay. I don't want to fight the crab. Crab is too tough. Too scary. Alright, we don't have an infinite amount of time. So let's go here, we'll drop off a couple of things, then we'll go to that shrine, rob it, and then we'll, I'm watching, okay, voodoo doll effect just ended. Let's go ahead and pop another one. On the whole, I think this has been a very successful expedition. Do I want any of this stuff? We probably want to take his medical supplies. Just like trade him some teeth or something. We could trade him the meat, actually, because we're not gonna need it. We just barely don't have enough meat. Trade you a can of food. Give me back one of these meats. Deal. Okay. And we'll throw this stuff, yeah, throw this stuff in there. Okay. Let's go ahead and eat our last meat, since there's no reason to hold on to it. It looks like we might not even have to use the other voodoo doll, which is pretty cool. Okay, the sound of rushing water. That's fine, we're about to go to a boat. You know what, let's take a moonstone with us. Okay, very successful. Come on. Yes, we got there first. We get to save a voodoo doll for the beginning of next expedition. And our inventory space is actually really good now. Alright, I'm extremely pleased with how that went. Oh, we didn't... Shoot, I totally wasn't thinking. I was thinking, oh, let's preserve our standing. But, or we didn't even see the village until the very end. But I should have tried to trade with them. I should have tried to rest there and traded them some teeth or something. Because I didn't get my anthropological study done. That's... Also, we know for a fact that they had a... Oh, that's not the button I wanted. We know that they had an idol. So our score could be better. I didn't put our lives in danger or anything. But our score could be a little higher than it is. That said, I think we're basically like... We're done, as long as we don't lose. Okay, Black Market is cool, but it's a lot cooler earlier. We are kind of set on supplies, like I think we're in a really good place, and an extra blue die would actually allow us to take advantage of a lot of our extra green dice more effectively. So I'm pretty pleased with that. Now we'll be able to do full rifle combo plus pull off a Ripper Leap still. should be pretty powerful. Alright, Roald Amundsen is having some issues. So what, we have 4 elephant tusks, so we don't have to worry about selling anything that isn't tusks. Which means I think I'm actually going to gift the raptor skins. We'll get some points out of those. I think we can go ahead and hold on to these now. We have the inventory space for it. Yep, and then I'll just sell all of those. Keep, and I guess sell. We probably should have gifted one of the tusks. Okay, well that's going to be it. Come back next time, you guys. I'm feeling pretty confident about this. Am I feeling confident enough to go to the Valley of Arctic and potentially throw it all away? Maybe. Come back next time to find out, and we'll see you then.